Welcome to Observe Enablement. In today's video, we'll be providing an intro to dashboards within Observe. To introduce dashboards within Observe, we'll be going over how to use dashboards within Observe, how to create them, and then we'll go into all of the different details on how to edit dashboards. And so let's jump right into using dashboards, where first we're going to look at the basic navigation of how to find dashboards and how to look at the data within them. And then we'll look at how to use various different parameters to filter our data within the dashboard. And then we'll show how we can drill into a dashboard and really investigate our data further. So let's jump into a quick demo just on how to use dashboards within Observe. So now that we're here within Observe, we can see that I'm now at the dashboard's main landing page. Here on the left menu, I can select the dashboards tab and see the long list of all dashboards within my Observe instance, which, depending on how many apps you have installed, may be extensive. You can expect to find your custom dashboards probably further towards the bottom with no app. Within this list, I can search for dashboards I care about, like the Kubernetes Home dashboard, and then navigate to it by clicking into it and see a top-level overview of all of my Kubernetes data. Note that this dashboard comes by default out of the box with the Kubernetes app. And so with the dashboard, I can see all of my different data tiles. I can scroll down to see various other tiles, and I can also notice there are different sections within my dashboard that can be collapsed or expanded. Lastly, you'll notice there's actually text sections within a dashboard that can help describe what's going on or provide instructions on how to use the dashboard most effectively. And I can look to the top right corner to see additional options for using a dashboard. The first one, most importantly, is changing the time range so I can change how far back or when I'm looking at specific data. I can change the time zone that I'm looking at. I can see the status of my query, cancel it, or refresh it. All of which is very familiar to a worksheet or a dataset. But up here, I can also see a create worksheet option, which will create a worksheet based on all of the different stages and tiles in this dashboard. I can save a link to this dashboard with or without the current filters and time to share to my other teammates. I can favorite this dashboard to come back and use later. I can save this to my home page by selecting a public folder already displayed on the home. And I can choose again whether or not I want to retain the current filters or time range. And lastly, I can use this pencil icon to edit the dashboard definition. Of course, we'll take a look at that further here in a moment. Now, this concludes how we might navigate a dashboard after we found it on the Dashboards tab here. But now we want to look a little bit closer into parameters within a dashboard and how we might use those to filter the data. And so there's two different types of dashboard parameters. The first one is a dataset filter, which you'll always find at the top of a dashboard within this top-level menu here. And when I click into a dataset filter, I might see one or more different resources or event streams that I can filter to. And I could select between those, and then once selected on one, I can see the relevant fields or columns that I can filter to. So in the case of this Kubernetes Home dashboard, I can filter to the name of this cluster by selecting on the field and selecting equals to the certain value that I want. And now my dashboard will update and show only the corresponding Kubernetes data for the cluster equal to Observe Demo. Now let's navigate to a different dashboard so to exemplify the other type of dashboard parameter. Here, looking at the OpenTelemetry Service Inspector dashboard, another one that comes out of the box, but this one from the OpenTelemetry app, has two parameters here which are dropdown parameters. Very different from dataset filters, dropdown parameters can be arranged within your dashboard however you'd like. They can be based on predefined custom input values, or the input values can be based upon the data itself. So I can choose different values and then see the dashboard update accordingly. Now there are different types of parameters similar to this dropdown parameter. These options include numeric parameters or open text parameters. However, we'll look more into parameters in a separate enablement video. And so if you'd like to learn on how to configure and create parameters within a dashboard, you'll need to look to that video outside of this one. Okay, so now we've taken a moment to appreciate how we'd use a dashboard in respect to navigating it, using parameters, and now we want to conclude by showing how we can drill into data within a dashboard. And so there's two main ways we can do that. We can, one, drill into linked data, and then we can also drill into dashboard cards themselves. And so the first way, by drilling into linked data, we can select any linked resource within a dashboard, as noted by the green highlighted value here. And when I select on it, pun intended, I can see that there's various values here in the right menu, similar to working with links in dashboards or worksheets. And then I can open this up to drill even further into this select operation and see all of the relevant data for spans that use this operation. Coming back to my OpenTelemetry Service Inspector dashboard, the second way we can drill into data, aside from links, is by going into the dashboard cards themselves. And so each individual dashboard card will have a little menu here, as shown by these ellipses, which when clicked, provide various options for helping work with this specific dashboard card. I can see all of the relevant content that is linked and used to provide this dashboard visualization. I can also copy the image so I can paste it in any presentation or Slack message that needs to be sent. And then finally, this option up here at the top is one of the ones most notable because if I open in a worksheet, I'm going to then be provided my own separate worksheet which recreates this exact dashboard card in my own separate Scratchpad. And so what I can do here is I can open up the Opal console, I can look to the visualization options here in the right menu, and I can edit this by changing the data or changing the visualization to look at this data even further. And thus concludes the different ways we can drill into data by starting from a dashboard. Now, before we move back into our presentation to talk more about creating dashboards and editing dashboards, it's worth pointing out here that while in a worksheet, we see these visualization options here on the right menu. Visualizing data within Observe is the crux of creating dashboards. And so this menu here should be very familiar whether you're configuring visualizations in a dashboard or a worksheet. Okay, and so now that we've seen how to use a dashboard, we're more motivated to understand how we would create a dashboard. And so to create a dashboard, we're going to want to look at how we can create one from scratch, we can create one from an existing dashboard, and we can also create dashboards from worksheets. And so without further ado, let's jump into another demo. Here back in Observe, I'm at the Dashboards tab under the Explore menu. Here I can see the list of dashboards, but I can also create a dashboard from scratch by clicking the New Dashboard button in the right-hand menu. And when I do that, as you might expect, I'm brought to a blank dashboard where I can immediately start adding cards. Now we'll get into editing a dashboard in just a moment, but let's go back to our Dashboards tab here, and then we can see how to create a dashboard in a different way. So in addition to creating dashboards from scratch, we can click into an existing dashboard, and then click on the Edit Dashboard Definition button in the right-hand menu. And from here, we could edit this dashboard however we'd like. For the sake of a simple demo, I'll just delete a section or delete another. And then I'll notice that I actually can't save these changes because this dashboard is out of the box. What I'll have to do is save it as a new dashboard. What I could have also done is clicked on these ellipses and duplicated this dashboard and started my editing from there. And now the third way we can create a dashboard is by creating one from a worksheet. And so I could click into an existing worksheet that I had already used to model out some data. Here I have my Scratch visualizations, in which I have multiple stages, each of which visualize a different metric for my OTel data. And so if I wanted to work on this throughout the week and save my progress, and then ultimately publish this to its own dashboard, all I need to do is go up in the right-hand menu of any worksheet, and I can click Add Worksheet to Dashboard. And I have two options. I can select an existing dashboard, or I can create a new dashboard. And then all of these cards from my worksheet that I just created which could also include parameters as well, are added to this dashboard, which I can save. And so that was a brief look into the three different ways we can create a dashboard and get to modeling data. And now we'll really dive into the details of editing dashboards. The first thing we'll look at when editing dashboards is dashboard cards. As we saw in the various different examples, those visualization cards, we'll see how to edit and create those. Of course, editing and creating those involves working with the different visualization options, and so we'll take a dedicated moment to appreciate those. And then we'll show some of the miscellaneous objects that can be created within a dashboard, things like sections, text cards, or images. Note that parameters, again, are covered in a separate enablement video. So let's demo one last time, and this will conclude how to use a dashboard, how to create one, and after we're done editing it, we'll be able to save it and share it amongst our team. So back into the Observe platform one last time for this dashboard enablement video. We're going to start from this dashboard main page and create a new dashboard from scratch to show how we can edit different visualization cards and set up our dashboard. And so the first thing I'll probably want to do is title my dashboard. And then I'll see an option here to add a card. When selected, I'll see there are various different options divided into a few different groups. The first group for dashboard cards really represents the different visualizations and the raw data that you'll ultimately want to show on your dashboard. And so let's add one card for each type to appreciate how they differ. So the first one, a dataset table, is going to prompt you to select a dataset within your environment. This, of course, can be any resource set or event stream that you'd like. In this case, I'll stick to a Kubernetes theme and look for container logs. And this exemplifies a dataset table card because I can show the raw data without really any visualization at all. So now let's add the second type of card, a dataset visualization. And here, I'm going to select a dataset again. And so to show some parity between a dataset table and a dataset visualization, I'm going to choose container logs again. And here, a default visualization is configured, and in this case, it looks like it's showing the count of container logs over time. This, of course, we'll be able to edit in just a moment, but let's conclude with the three different types of dashboard cards and select the metric visualization. And here, I can then search for any of the different metrics within my environment. Container might lead me in the wrong direction here, looking at AWS ECS containers. And so I'm going to look for CAdvisor derived metrics, which I know has the machine memory utilization. So let's select that. And now we can see, represented by these three stages, three different dashboard cards. So now let's go into editing each of these cards, and here we'll get to appreciate the visualization options. So now editing my dataset table card, the first thing I want to do is edit the default stage name, which represents the title of this card on my dashboard. And so I'll name this something to represent what the data is showing. And now I can change how this data is being displayed. One of the things I might want to use is the table controls, so I can hide all of the data or columns that I don't really care about. I might just want to look at my container logs in the most relevant infrastructure that is running that. And okay, now I have just the log message and some of the basic metadata here available. If I go back to my dashboard up in the left menu, I can see this change reflected in my dashboard card along with the title, but this is a little scrunched up, so I'm probably gonna wanna rearrange this to extend the full length of the dashboard. And then I can also rearrange these column sizes. And this will stick after saving the dashboard. So let's go now into the visualization card and start editing that. Again, I want to change the title. And then really, I might not need to change anything else. If anything, I can change how this data is being visualized by changing the group by statement to show the number of logs per pod. And then I can see which services are emitting the most data. Now here to the right, you'll notice this visualization menu, very similar to what we saw in worksheets, gives me the ability to change what data is being visualized, what visualization type I'm using, And anytime I make a change here, I'm going to want to click Apply so it'll reflect it in the stage. Okay, and so I'm done with this card now, and I could go back to my dashboard to then select the last card and start editing it, but I want to point out that we can navigate between different cards in a dashboard by using the Editing Card button up here in the top center. And so here I see the two other cards that are in my dashboard, which I can select and then immediately start editing. And here I have my Kubernetes node memory utilization and metrics within Observe, like the one here defined in this dataset, come with metadata that should help create the default visualization appropriately. And so here there's really nothing I need to change. I can go back to my dashboard and rearrange these two cards. And that will conclude how I can then create different visualization cards and edit them within a dashboard. And so we're nearly finished with introducing how to create a dashboard. The last thing to point out for this basic introduction is the objects that can be added to a dashboard. Again, filters and parameters will be described in a separate enablement video. And so for the objects, I can click a section and then title it. And a section provides a way of grouping different visualization cards so that they can be collapsed or re-expanded. One cool fact to note is that if I collapse a section and then change my query, anything hidden within a section will not run the actual query, thus improving the performance of your dashboard. And so sections can be a great way of giving the option for displaying a lot of data while not having to query all of that data if you don't need it. And so now let's add another object, this time a text object, which very much resembles a visualization card in how it can be rearranged and sized. But once edited, we just get a simple editing menu where we can use Markdown to display whatever we'd like. Then last but not least, you can add an image to your dashboard. Here, clicking on the edit icon will prompt you to select an image URL. And so if you have an image hosted on any cloud site, this could be S3, a public bucket. You could use that public URL to paste it here. One pro tip for using an image within a dashboard to help bring a custom feel is instead of hosting an image online and providing that hosted URL, you can go to Google, find whatever image you want to use and copy it, and then Google a tool for converting a PNG to a data URI. Just about any will do, from which you can paste your image. Sometimes it'll prompt you for however it needs to get it, but then it provides you this really long string, which if copied, and then I can use this really long string to somehow provide an image in my dashboard. And this resizing behavior can be used for situations in which the height or width doesn't exactly match up, and so that can help constrain it and display my image properly. And there we go. That concludes creating a dashboard here in Observe. All I need to do now is save. And then when I leave the editor or navigate to this dashboard from the dashboards page, this is exactly what I'll see. So in conclusion today, we've been able to go over how we might navigate Observe to find dashboards and then how we'll use them in Observe. Then we went into how we can create dashboards in different ways and all of the different things we can do to edit and customize our dashboard to our liking. And so with dashboards in Observe, we believe they are the start but never the end, because being able to drill into the data opens the door for not only high-level overviews but also deep dives and investigations. Thank you for joining us today with Observe Enablement. We hope to see you again to learn more.